What will it cost and how to build a social network like Twitter? You might have an idea for a certain audience like sports fans, top managers, bookmakers, bettors, and so on. By the end of this video, you will learn a step-by-step guide on how to make a social app like Twitter, the pricing model, and the deadly mistakes you will need to avoid in your startup. My name is Denis Babich, and I'm the founder and CEO of a software consultancy and development agency called Debito Limited. So, let's get started. Let me tell you the truth. Recreating Twitter isn't a good idea. What you need to do is to create a better version of Twitter that allows you to make money using your new, unique idea for your specific niche audience by using basic functionality that already exists, while you can focus on developing a new core feature that might be a game changer for your audience, for instance, an innovative AI algorithm or an Ethereum blockchain-based solution. Interesting? Let's dive deeper. Okay, let's start from basics. Inside Twitter's business model, there's a few core elements. You've got the client app that allows people to use the social network and the web-based admin zone to manage your users, the content, disputes, and much more. Inside the client app, you can find user profiles, followers, chats, news feeds, and so on. Also, your new app will have to have your new unique feature that Twitter is missing. In the table here, I've added approximate hours to develop each, so you can get an idea of the time your software engineers will need. Inside the web admin zone, you can manage your users, content, disputes, and more. Pricing is tough, because many people totally forgot to include things like quality assurance, bug fixing, project management, maintenance, and risks. Also, you should keep in mind the cost to develop your unique feature. It's hard to guesstimate the price right now, so that's why I'll show you the price only for core functionality. Life hack: if you need an in-house development team because your investor's contract requires it, the social network development costs of an app like Twitter you can find in the US or EU lines. But if you can build it anywhere, you can reduce your expenditures by outsourcing software development to Ukraine without losing the quality. Lots of startups are already doing it. Companies like GitLab, Grammarly, Jubal, and many more have seen the logic of hiring Ukrainian developers to build world-class software. It's a value for money. First of all, you have to focus on creating your minimum viable product. So let's say you want to develop a better social network for sports betting, something where bookies, capers, and players get value from. Focus on one core feature, something like blockchain and smart contract bets on a sporting event. Because smart contracts can easily increase the transparency of the odds and provide a guaranteed transfer of any winnings without delay and bureaucracy. And then you can use basic social features like user profiles, chat messaging, searches, news feeds, and more. Focus on creating the MVP that adds value to your audience without costing too much. So if you want to develop your MVP, then you have to follow these 10 simple steps. Lean Canvas is one of the best tools to plan out your idea in these early stages. First of all, you have to identify your target audience and where a social network like Twitter isn't really helping them. What kind of functionality does your audience need? What features they would love to have? Also, you have to identify potential competitors or alternative solutions that might already exist and solve the problems of your audience right now. The next one is your unfair advantage. What kind of thing may significantly increase your chances of success? Maybe you've got a big following on Twitter already, so you can bring this community to your network instead of paying for ads. So that will help you to keep your user acquisition costs down. Also, you have to think about your early adopters and where they spend their time online, and how you can motivate them to migrate to your platform. But don't just think in the present terms. Map out the future and your expansion internationally, painting a picture of what your Twitter's clone will look like in 5 or 10 years is highly important because your investors are looking for a future vision, a big dream, and how can you potentially reach the unicorn status. Oh, and remember to include your expenditures, revenue streams, and analytics. Guys, if you've enjoyed the insights, please subscribe to my channel and hit the like button because it will help me to boost this video in the YouTube algorithm. Okay, so if you want to create a successful startup, you have to achieve the product market fit. You have to start thinking outside the box to be able to create disruptive and innovative solutions for your target audience. That's why you have to properly complete your value proposition table. Picture this. You have an audience that likes betting on sport events. They following popular accounts of professional gamblers to get a piece of inside information and win more bets. Right now, they might use Twitter and face problems like Caper's account can be easily banned or suspended on Twitter. Bookmakers can block user accounts and not pay winnings. It's hard to see a track record from a successful Caper. Account, odds, stats, and results are split across many websites. To fix these issues, you could develop new features such as creating a standalone app where you have full control. Smart contracts on a blockchain for transparency and trust winnings bets are paid out. Valid performance ratings generated from smart contracts betting history. All-in-one app for all of your accounts, odds, stats, and results. But why just stop there? There are other cool features your audience might love, such as paid subscriptions for sports forecasts and betting tips, premium content to access exclusive statistics and analytics, ranking and leadership for Caper's forecasts accuracy. And who knows what other great ideas might come up as you build your Twitter's clone. Because once you've made this solution available for your audience, you will start to see higher quality posted content from top capers. More and more sport forecasts are added to your platform. New ideas for capers to monetize their content and earn big. An actively engaged community will create explosive growth and a snowball effect. I know, it's really a lot of new information, but if you have any questions, please feel free to ask them in the comments down below, and I'll personally get back to you. Sounds good? If you want to develop a social network like Twitter, then you should never do it from scratch. Just copy the functions, functionality, and business logic that already exist. It will help you to decrease the software development time. On top of that, you could look at the community forums and betting platforms for additional ideas and inspiration. Don't forget that when you create something well known to your users, then it will be more comfortable for them to use your social network, and you can focus your time on building new features that really make a hit. Story mapping is a really powerful tool that allows you to build your MVP fast, because any must-have functionality can be quickly identified, developed, and released. You just need to focus on getting your minimum viable product out as fast as possible. Time-consuming things such as a complicated algorithm for a newsfeed or a comprehensive admin zone can be done in future releases and updates. UX design is a critical thing for organizing your ideas from the value proposition research into a simple user flow. In our case, a social network for betting will have core functionality like user profiles, chats, newsfeeds, and so on. Any missing use cases? So what would happen if a match between Manchester United and Arsenal was postponed? Any money in the blockchain is frozen until the results of the match is released. So how do we resolve the smart contract and get any bettors their money back if the match doesn't happen? UI design is one of the easiest parts. Just compare the big platforms like Facebook, Twitter, Reddit, Instagram, and perhaps even LinkedIn. And you will find many similar things. It's a simple white and blue design centered around the newsfeed, arguably the most valuable functionality of a social network. So what do you need to do? Just make the same strong focus on your unique and valuable feature, so there is nothing else distracting your users. you can get tons of cool ideas for your Twitter's design from websites like Behance or Dribbble. Just search for betting apps and do what the greatest artists are doing. Copy the parts you like. A software development approach is slightly different from a traditional business model because your app has to stay modern and updated regularly on the fast-changing demands of your audience. But if you get your tech stack wrong or overcomplicate things, it can trigger more problems such as it's hard to change your developers, painfully slow user interface, the cloud infrastructure is non-scalable and non-maintainable, highly expensive technology stack, issues with payments, and risks that your entire app might go offline if traffic spikes. So, if you're planning to develop a Twitter's clone properly, it's important to choose the right tech stack from the beginning because it will help you to create your minimum viable product fast. You have to choose something like Flutter for iOS and Android. That way, you would have the same code base for both mobile apps. Also, languages and frameworks such as Python, Django, Node.js, and Amazon Web Services for your backend will help you to produce your software easily and on time. Oh, and while we are speaking about betting app with blockchain technology in the background, then don't forget to use something like Ethereum and Solidity. Also, you can use third-party services if you want to increase the speed. Tools like Stripe for payment processing, Twilio for SMS, and SendGrid for emails. Just stay away from overhyped technologies that are too difficult to manage. PHP, Ruby, React, Perl, .NET, and Solana aren't good fit for social apps. And you will dig yourself into a hole. The right tech stack is like a proper diagnosis after a blood test. Guys, if you are still with me, please do me a favor. Just go ahead and click the like button and subscribe. It takes just 1 or 2 seconds, but it will help me reach more people on my YouTube channel. Oh, and save this video to your playlist, so you can watch it again later. Moving to Agile. Agile is a powerful tool if you want to increase your speed. But did you know that in some situations, Agile can slow down the project speed up to 30%? Let's say you have a team of 5 developers and each knows their tasks and responsibilities. They have good communication, they know what to do, and because they've built most of the product, code updates are done easily. So you can have a highly effective process using just simple tools like Trello, Asana, Google Docs, shared meetings, and so on. Too good to be true, right? But one day your team will start growing to 15 or more people. So, unexpected problems will start to occur. Key developers will unfortunately leave the team. The onboarding process will become really complex and time-consuming. Team productivity levels will start to fall. Communication issues will happen more often. Deadlines and delivery dates will be pushed out. Code and architecture quality will go down. So, if you want to get rid of these issues, you will have to hire a tech lead to manage the team and code architecture, hire a technical project manager, set up processes like Scrum, Sprints, Backlog, and Retrospective, run a daily stand-ups and updates on pending tasks, use more advanced tools like Jira for management and velocity. Last but not the least is in analytics. You have to pay enough attention to your metrics, such as unique visitors, user behaviors, and common user sessions, and tools like Google Analytics, Session Stack, Firebase, and Mixpanel will help you to figure out what's going on. Regular health check will help you to find out the things that you have to improve and identify hidden client needs. You know, my social network development team has built 3 Twitter clones that have done really well. And I'd like to help you turn your idea into a winner. So, just click the link below to book a 30-minute call with me, and I'll answer all your questions. See ya!